Yo, what's going on, guys? It is your boy Seso here. We got a video here today. We're gonna have a brand new video, best five, or I guess my best five Photoshop features and tools that should help you guys out with navigation as well as organization within the program and pretty much overall just increase your workflow. So rather if you're like a complete beginner, this video that you're watching right now is complete gold, and I highly recommend you just definitely subscribe if you're new to the videos as well. But even if you're like 2, 3, 4, 5 years into Photoshop, there's gonna be like a 70% chance that you have no idea what I'm talking about in this video, and you're gonna learn something. So that's the plan, that's the hope. I do hope you guys do enjoy today's video today. And as I usually say, paranormal, please just leave a like if you guys like it, and comment down anything you wanna see me do personally below. But yeah, enjoy it, and hopefully you learn something again. All right, homies, so the first tool is gonna be endlessly helpful for those dealing with many cutouts of objects, people, or frequently used assets. And what I'm referring to is known as libraries. A tab you probably frequently misclick, but super helpful because you can actually store assets you use a lot within them. Under Windows Libraries, simply click on the plus button near the bottom right of the tab and choose New Library. With this, you can name it whatever topic the library will consist of, and you're ready to start dragging in your assets. Now, all you have to do is click on the layer, whether if it's a cutout, text, literally anything, and just drag your layer into the library. And now, just like that, it's stored for future use. Then to use the asset once again in a different project, you can just simply click on the layer in the library tab itself and drag it out. Now, wherever you are in the world, your library is actually cloud linked through your Adobe account. So now all the assets you ended up saving can be used throughout many computers. Quick, simple, and easy, with the option as well to actually share your libraries with other people with Adobe accounts for them to use as well. So if you reuse a lot of assets or cutouts, libraries can be your best friend. Up next for organization is the colored layer and the find feature. If you are unaware, you can actually color coordinate your layers within Photoshop for really easy visual reference. So, for example, if you choose to make every circle layer in your project red, you can easily see where they are on your layers panel. Now, that part is pretty obvious, but let's say you have 200 layers, you want to quickly see all of your red layers in one glance. Something that is actually consistently looked past is the find feature below your layers panel. Here you can specify you only want to see one color in the layers. Then you can also choose a specific color, and for my instance, that would be red. Now I can see all of my circle layers quickly, then hide and show them faster to see if I like my project better with or without some. With the find feature, you can also search for layers with specific attributes, which honestly come in handy when cleaning up your document. One that I think that you will frequently end up using is selecting attribute, then in the dropdown you can now search for layers that are hidden, locked, or empty. So if I were to end up choosing empty, I can quickly see all the layers that contain nothing inside them and select them and delete them. So now, when your project gets into the hundreds and you also have a bunch of groups, color coordinating and the find feature will end up being super essential in organizing yourself within your document. Next heads up feature for keeping yourself organized or just get lost less in your project. So towards the right of your layers tab is the options button. When you click it, you can select the panel options, and here you can change the size of your preview thumbnails in your layers tab. But for many, that's not really newfound knowledge. Something that's actually looked over a lot, since it's not really default or really brought to your attention, however, is the thumbnail contents option. Here, when selected on layer bounds, your layer thumbnail preview will now showcase up close the content within it. So now besides having your layer showing the full document, it'll be easier for someone to see what is now exactly in the actual layer. So for example here, if you guys use icons or objects, cutouts, this feature will be your absolute best friend. While hopefully also stop you guys from hiding and unhiding layers for about 3 minutes just to find really small assets. The next tip I have to share is actually super small and quick, but I actually rediscovered it recently when I was streaming on Twitch. Now, that little tip would actually be holding Alt on your keyboard and selecting the layer I to view only what is actually contained in that layer alone in your project. Then simply selecting the layer I again to re-show everything as it was before. It can come in handy with projects that contain a bunch of different assets. However, keep in mind, if you hold Alt-click on a layer eye to end up seeing this feature, but you don't hold Alt-click when selecting the actual eye once again, it will reset your canvas's visible layers. And pretty much you have to go through and actually unhide all of your layers again. It doesn't end up sounding like much of an issue until you guys realize you didn't clean up your hidden layers and things you don't want anymore. So if you guys do hold Alt and you click on the layer eye, just make sure you hold Alt and click on the layer eye again to re-show everything. And now for my final tip that'll forever be used as my most used feature inside Photoshop, that would actually end up being using the Move tool in order to select and find objects quickly within my project. When selected on the Move tool, which is V on your keyboard for the shortcut, Towards the right of the toolbar option Auto Select is a drop-down menu that you should change from Group to Layer. So now when you end up holding Control on your keyboard and select on the canvas, it will automatically grab the layer that you are looking for, which just ends up making things you want to move a lot quicker and fluent for your workflow. Something I think that should be absolutely super staple and just frequent in your usage in Photoshop every single day, and if you don't know it, now you do. Alright guys, that's the end of the video here today, so once again, come on, tell me you learned at least something. If you didn't learn anything, that's my fault. But I feel like you guys are gonna take something away, at least one thing, you're gonna be like, dang, I'm gonna use that right now, and I'm gonna hop into Photoshop, and you're gonna have a good ass time. So, with that being said, I love you guys, I appreciate you guys, thank you so very much for watching. Of course, again, if you guys have not left a like yet, please be sure to do so. If you haven't subscribed yet, please be sure we can be friends. And I love you guys. Told you guys later, so HQ out. You're having to keep smiling, stay positive, and stay freaking productive, guys. Later, much love, and enjoy your weekend.